DJ?
What's up, man? How you doing? It's good, man. It's nice to meet
yo,
you.
Yo, DJ!
What's
up,
man?
Yeah, we can do a bitch, no problem. Yeah, all good. All good.
Alright, cool, man.
Can you do my voicemail?
Oh, yeah. I got your voicemail.
Name's Xander.
Name's Xander?
Yeah.
Hey, what's up? It's your boy, DJ. Xander can't come to the phone right now, so leave a message after the tone. Peace.
Sorry, one more photo.
Oh, yeah, I got you, man. No problem, no problem.
Awesome. Thanks,
I
DJ.
Appreciate the support, guys. Alright?
Later, DJ.
I'll see you. Thank you.
the one.
Sports pregame show.
Welcome, NBA fans. Ernie Johnson here with you again, and we've got Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal, and we're all amped up for this early season game. Tonight, we'll see the Los Angeles and for Utah, this is a team they knocked out in the first round in last year's playoffs, so they better be ready. Some extra motivation on this one.
Here's Mitchell. He picked up 12 points in their last win against Oklahoma City.
Hey.
offense can't get it to go. On defense, Utah. DJ kicks to Griffin. Over Favors. Back to Griffin. Over Gobert. Griffin's shot is off.
Well, yeah, I mean, you want to give your offense a chance, and that possession didn't do it.
Not at all, Brad. I mean, no reason for him to be taking these kinds of shots. He has only himself to blame.
Broke loose.
Dude, I hope you die.
Bounce it up for Jordan. And so falls out of bounds.
What are you doing?
Just around a minute and a half into the first quarter. Jordan the screen and the clock.
That sucks.
Up top Griffin. He's covered by Favors. Jordan dishes to DJ. Back to Jordan. Over Gobert.
What aggressive defense from the lane.
He's got two rebounds.
Mitchell. The Jazz again can't hit it. Clippers have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Now here's DJ. Guarded close. Goes back up.
Go in.
And Jordan with the layup. Jordan's got his second bucket tonight.
Yeah, and it's the long arms of Jordan. Staying active on the boards for these high percentage putbacks.
Great, when you look at all the dunks that DeAndre Jordan has on his resume, it's pretty impressive.
And Jordan, I feel, is even underrated with his dunking ability. Very agile. You can see that in warm-ups as well as the dunk contest. His
don't care.
Power
when here to play basketball.
He may be the best athlete in the league.
And that replay brought to us by Under Armour. Another Unleash Chaos moment. One of the more exciting plays in basketball.
Come on.
Jazz trail by five. And Rubio kicks to Gobert. Dishes up to Ingles. Ingles with a screen. Here's Favors. Jordan with the rebound. Jordan's got his third rebound tonight from 13. And it's
dude, my guy sucks.
Last outing for the Clippers, they won that game against Phoenix.
And in that one, it was all about shutting down the paint. They were just terrific in terms of their rim protection.
Well, I mean, that's exactly how you have to protect the basket, right? Exceptional job setting the tone on the defensive end, deep at the rim.
Kicks it to Jordan. Side Williams. At the elbow is DJ.
Go! Pulls it in. What am I, 0-for-4?
Offensively, but he continues to work at it.
Well, you can see he's sputtering a bit, but he's trying to get going. I do like that he's continuing to be aggressive.
Griffin passes to Williams. Gallinari outside. Some nice ball movement by the Clippers. Jordan the screen. Shot off the screen.
Are you kidding me?
It's the Clippers missing. They time it right, they can end this quarter with a 2-for-1.
And that's how you want to end the quarter.
Out to the wing. Now the feed to Gobert.
Well, that actually sucks.
They double him with DJ.
He picked up the ball.
Now, here's Ingles.
This game is cheap, bro.
Well, that's the size of Derek Favors allowing him to snag these boards. This guy, you've got to keep him off the offensive glass, Kevin.
DJ dishes to Griffin. To the wing right side.
There.
That one a tad offline to the right, but drops in for him. Mitchell. A shot. No good.
Whoever's watching, if you're still watching, put a comment and say who's watching. Say who's watching this terrible performance.
And Clippers head coach Doc Rivers told us
step myself up.
Expectations are good. I try to remind you.
This guy's not scoring. What's his score? 27-15.
We've got 1:13 left here in the second. Williams and Gallinari at the 2 and the 3. Griffin and Jordan the front court. And it's DJ.
Have my boys in DeAndre and Blake.
Up on the floor for the Clippers. Beavers with the ball. And Griffin picks him up defensively. And it's Mitchell missing.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them.
There we go.
Oh my.
I went in for 5 seconds, got taken out.
Thank you, David, and we'll be right back after halftime. And now the third quarter has to get going. We've seen Derek Favors really having a great game.
Oh, what the heck? Went for 0.5 seconds. I ain't gonna see him. Great.
DJ, you ready to go?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Hey, yo, what's up? You bring your counselor?
I got you.
Nice. Hey, I brought my controller this time, too. Ain't gonna be no funny here.
Hey, you know what they say. Those who can do, and those who can't blame the controller.
I'm gonna get out of here. Yo, Freshie, what you gonna get up to now? Rook out the house.
I'm gonna have my team fresh lettuce come through and practice.
Now, hold on. You better not wreck my place.
talking about all this fresh lettuce stuff.
The money that I don't have. Freeze? No. I had to go get paid. Wow, that's a lot. Ooh. Let's upgrade my guy, though. I'm gonna show it again. Yeah, how much money do I have? 781.
Sports pregame show.
Welcome, NBA fans. Ernie Johnson here with you again, and we've got Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal, and we're all amped up for this early season game. Our game tonight featuring the Portland Trail Blazers as they go up against the Los Angeles Clippers. Looking at Los Angeles, they're coming in off a win in their last game against Utah, continuing their winning streak.
Welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
is in beautiful Portland. And David Aldridge is standing by for our pregame report. David, good evening.
Well, thank you, Kevin. Now, Lehigh, CJ.
It certainly has, D.A. Love the mindset McCollum has, stepping right into the starting two-guard spot with great confidence. And in these early stages prep for the season, how quickly do you start to get a sense of where your team... and how good they can be, or how bad they might be. And Davis is checked in for Nurkic. Aminu comes in for Turner. And it's Napier in for Damian Lillard. The Clippers also changing it up. Reed is checked in for DeAndre Jordan. Rivers comes in for Lou Williams. And DJ is subbed in for Patrick Beverley. Setting the floor for the Clippers. Gallinari, the three with Griffin at the four. DJ out there with Austin Rivers. And it's Reed with the pivot spot manning the middle. Shot from 12. Gets the front of the rim and out. Trailblazers trail by five. Here's Napier. No good with the triple. Now about 3 minutes gone in the first quarter. A quick look, no good that time.
Low percentage look on that one. Not sure what he was thinking. Sometimes you get a little outside of yourself. You have to be a little more disciplined.
Davis sets a screen. And a wide open look for McCollum. Again, McCollum missing. Gallinari kicks to DJ. Reed dishes to Griffin. Kinchin shot. He takes it up and lays it in. Griffin's got seven. The Trailblazers have gone just a shade under 50% from the field. Five of 11. McCollum outside. We've got 118 left to play here in the first.
And he is really playing and scoring for
Pat Connaughton, he's checked in for Bonley. And then for Los Angeles. Harrell, he's checked in for Griffin. And Wells is subbed in for Gallinari. Reed is screened. DJ passes to Reed. Can't get it to Paul.
And you know what? You can't get a better screen. Frees him up beautifully. But he just fails to capitalize.
That's laid plans, right? Well, I tell you right there, though, that's one they'll take every single time.
And so he draws the foul on the shot. And trip to the line to shoot two. And you look at the Clippers post Chris Paul. The team is still in a position to compete.
I think they have to fill in gaps when players left, but I really like the job they've done overall. I mean, they have good inside and outside presence. Not the same, but they aren't in a horrible spot.
Davis sends a screen. McCollum outside. Easy layup after coming off the pick. 15 points in the game.
McCullough is fantastic at running the screen and roll. He knows how to use the pick to get space to shoot.
Down low. Out of bounds, Portland's edge possession.
He has got nothing to do with that turnover. It just forces it. That's just plain sloppy pass.
Dan Ozic is just... Here in the second quarter, about 3 minutes played, taking a look at Los Angeles. Williams and Gallinari at the two and the three.
Takes forever to jump. Holy crap, man.
Lillard capitalizing in the paint is a beautiful thing. Fantastic score, especially this close to
the line. And stolen by Lillard. The numbers in their favor. Moving it up. Here's McCollum. And counted. A chance for one more at the free throw line.
Defensively, this is what you know. He's coming off a hot game and looking to keep it rolling.
Yeah, but here's the problem. They play team ball. So if you pay him too much attention, that just leaves other guys open and it's too difficult of an adjustment to make.
Reed is screened. Gallinari kicks to DJ. It's not the run. And the foul called out.
What are you talking about?
His first foul of the game.
Yeah, way to get there.
Throwing random crap at me. I went to shoot.
Closing in on 4 minutes played here in the second quarter. And Lillard kicks to McCollum. Davis sets a screen. Lillard from outside. hauled in by the Clippers. They put up a nice run against Utah last time out.
And how about the defensive adjustments in that one? Their communication.
Gotta tell you to pass to him now.
All night. But they really worked well together. They trusted each other. That's how you get stops.
McCollum against Williams. Davis setting the pick for McCollum. Kicks it out to Lillard. Net ball. Nice shoot that time for McCollum. Lillard's got 5 points so far.
McCollum is always a winner. Fantastic skipping the ball over to the open nose.
And Damian Lillard said he's committed to finishing his career in Portland. Title or not, he's invested in this franchise.
A team first, though, that helps all the players buy in. And new additions have to fall in line with example. He said the culture won't change because he won't allow it to happen.
And they're getting to the line a lot in this quarter, guys, and it hasn't been by accident.
Here's Connaughton, calling a recovery. Davis sets a screen. Five to shoot. And it's Connaughton missing.
Even that close to the bucket, that's a very tough finish in that contract.
Free throw line jump shot. Second chance effort. A nice shot by Reed.
And you just hate to give up those second chance points. It can be discouraging, frustrating, but you only have yourselves to blame. Box out.
No good on that last shot on the technique. For the great interview, David, and we'll be back for the third.
God.
Welcome back, everybody. The start of the second half getting underway. Both teams. Look now for Portland. Davis has checked in for Yusuf Nurkic.
I mean, for 10 seconds.
For Turner, and it's Napier in for CJ McCollum. Damian Lillard out there with Dave. Then there's Al Farouk Aminu, then there's Davis, and it's Bonlay in at the four-man position. That's the group on the floor for Portland. Harrell, it's rebounded by Bonlay. Bonlay has got three rebounds now in this one. And Aminu kicks to Nathan. There's 57 seconds left here in the third quarter. Off target from outside. Clippers trail by five. Now the pass to Teodosic. He frames the quick shot.
But you know what? Sometimes something good can come out of a bad possession.
For Portland, they've gone 7 for 16 the second half from the field, shooting a bit under 50%. Napier kicks to Lillard. Davis sets a screen. Again, the miss by the Trailblazers.
As off the mark as he has been, they're a little lucky to be a foul.
Boy, a lot of contact here, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
Out of respect to how DJ handles himself on the court.
He's had four chances at the line, made them all. And the
dude, oh my. Kill myself.
And then for Los Angeles. Blake Griffin, he's checked in for Willie Reed. And it's Gallinari in for Teodosic. Here's Napier. Turner with the screen. There's the pick. Napier kicks to Turner. Good.
Kill yourself.
Turner is going to take him up and begin to go.
And that would have been turnover. So does my teammate drop the ball.
And let's listen to head coach Terry Stotts review the game plan with his guy.
Don't care what you had to say.
And so it's Portland.
When you stay in my team's booty hole, or I'm booty hole. Suicide. What's up? Snag, go crazy. Am I getting kicked off the team? Off my back. That's what that means. Pre-game show.
Hello, basketball fans. I'm Ernie Johnson, welcoming you to 2K Sports. I'm here with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. And it's happening out at Staples Center, where the Los Angeles Clippers will be going up against the Detroit Pistons. Well, for Detroit, this is their first time facing off this season. Last year, they split the season series at a game apiece.
You look old, man. Fucking old. after all. One for one. Where's my rebounder?
In the front court. You get the feeling, Steve, that they'll be going. A different look for the Clippers. Austin Rivers, he's checked in for Williams. And DJ subbed in for Patrick Beverley. And Detroit, looking at who they picked. Jackson and Bradley are in the backcourt. Inside, it's Harris and Drummond. And it's Johnson in at the three spot. Griffin with the steal. Rivers gets a wide open look.
Oh, my shoulder.
That's how you play the game. Draw two defenders, kick it out to the wide open man for a bucket.
Outside Jackson. And the bucket counts. 3-point chance here. And setting.
Stop playing defense.
First quarter, you're really testing the defense. Trying to find their weaknesses.
Catching up on the changes for the Clippers. Reed comes in for Jordan, and it's Harrell in for Blake Griffin. John Lurie checked in for the Pistons.
Dude, are you kidding? They don't want me to score.
A good finish at the rack off the slick feed. Jackson's got 5 points so far.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
An easy layup after coming off the pin.
Aggressive move by DJ. Once he sees the opening, you know he's in.
Jackson kicks to Drummond. Over Reed, and it's Drummond missing.
Well, this is why you see guys shine away from the mid-range jumper. It's a bit of a lost art.
Here's Rivers, and again Los Angeles with the triple.
Gallinari, very unselfish, draws a lot of defensive attention, which often leads to open teammates.
Here's Jackson, the putback.
Where you at?
On the putback.
See, this is how you dictate the flow of the game. He's been lit this quarter.
Now, here's DJ. This is it to Reed. And Gallinari kicks to DJ.
Go in.
Detroit leading by four. Pass to Lou. And it's DJ with the rebound.
That's just two tough competitors meeting right at the rim. Someone, in my opinion, had to lose.
Moving it around, eight of the last ten coming off assists.
Take dubs. We don't take L's anymore.
Lure the screen. Outside Jackson, shot off the pick. Offensive rebound. Lure dishes to
was watching. Let's go. Can I throw an alley on my... What? Get out, bro. I mean, I'm about to get out. You're gonna take me out. I'm still in. Give me the ball, cuz. Go give me the ball.
Picked by Harrell. DJ passes to Harrell. Rivers kicks to DJ. Shot clock at 5. Tries from 16.
had to shoot. The buzzer beater. Whoever's watching, comment. No way to figure out who's watching.
And I think it's because we've always had that type of relationship where he's always kind of just been a father slash.
I never knew that.
Group substitution here for the Clippers. DeAndre Jordan's checked in for Reed. Comes in for Montrezl Harrell. Gallinari, he's checked in for Rivers. And DJ is subbed in for Teodosic. And while most teams are moving in the direction of attacking from three-point range or inside, break this Pistons
I'll
team
check it.
Will still look
to take me out.
In the mid-range game.
Yeah, and the Pistons right at the top of the NBA in terms of the highest percentage of their points coming from the mid-range.
Put that in. That's how you do it. He's a beast.
You have to play to the strengths of your team, even in an ever-evolving game right now. That's where their bread is buttered.
The heart of the team at the four and the five. Griffin and Jordan. Wells is out there with DJ.
Dude, I hope you die.
Patterson's out there for the Clippers.
No, they didn't put enough body on Drummond. Too much talent for that. He's gone 1-1 in the game so far in the long run. That's the guy you want to see at the line too often. See the numbers. That's him in the bottom tier of the league.
Attacking the defense. Yes, I do. Okay.
Jackson passes to Bradley. Gallinari against Johnson. Misses that one. He's
in my rebound.
And missed two this game so far. DJ with it. Jackson on him. Wells kicks to DJ. Griffin a screen on Jackson. To the inside. And Griffin scores. The assist by DJ.
My boy Blake popping the shot.
You gotta feed Griffin the basketball. He has it going so far down in the low block.
Drumming the screen. Harris drives in. And he got the whistle.
Come on.
3-point play opportunity.
Damn. This is way too loud.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of action. Here we go now, the start of the third quarter, welcoming you back.
Excuse me.
And so
really?
The W, they came in here and took care of business.
Should put me in. I had to put on my sweatshirt, I'm cold. It's only human after all. Tell me to come over. Don't wanna. Which ones look fresh? Okay, I gotta stop at his house or his office. I'm gonna wait till I'm overall at least 70 to play him playground or whatever. Well, that's just shooting around. That's a timer. Huh. We'll try that next. It's your boy.
What's up, Ryan? Say yes, something
fun? I do indeed. There you go.
Thanks, man.
How much? 175. Oh my god. He looks up some weird stuff. I don't know how to do this. Dude, are you kidding me? Wow. That's the high score. Midway, all 3 points. Dang it, I keep hitting the wrong button. No one cares. I'm a million after all. No one cares who you are.
We're already getting the feel for this new NBA season. Taking it all in with me, Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. Tonight, we'll be watching the Los Angeles Clippers playing against the Golden State Warriors. And for Golden State, coming into this matchup with no shortage of confidence, they won all 4 games against this team last season. Tonight, 2 teams that have had great success, the kind of battle that could have
Okay. Let's no one likes Warriors, so yeah.
From the Staples Center, joined in the booth with Greg Anthony and Brett Berry, this is Kevin Harlan, our sideline. For the Clippers, then for the Warriors, Valley's checked in for Pachulia. Caspi comes in for Draymond Green, and it's Iguodala in for Kevin Durant, setting the floor for the Warriors. Thompson at the two with Iguodala playing the three. Caspi is out there with Valley.
Is that me? Oh my.
And Kevin, they need to be consistent with their effort on the boards. You look at the box score, and they're at a definite disadvantage.
We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. He dishes it to Thompson. They set the pick. Livingston passes to Bell. Some solid defense from Reed.
Well executed. Great rhythm. You've got to finish that one.
Well, it's like Thanksgiving out there, carving out space off the screen.
Go in.
Thompson for the triple.
It's not that hard to fall into a basket hoop.
Ray Thompson is. And a chance to hear from DeAndre Jordan, who talks about the.
Doc told me, you know, you should be defensive.
And you gotta love how the passion.
Like, for real. Kill yourself. Ronnie.
What do you guys think about the Warriors here so far?
You suck. You're like, no one likes you.
To me, it's all about their deep. There's a lot of ways to build a lead. This one's built on stops.
AJ out there with us. Clippers.
Yeah, okay.
Then there's Wells, and it's Reed at the center. That's who's out there for the Clippers.
And the Clippers are known as a high wire act.
They do it.
So this team is also one that can at times lock it down defensively. I don't think they get enough.
Golden State's nothing for us.
Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Guys, Kevin Durant is a unique player. LeBron James said he's a seven-footer with six-foot ball handling skills, jump shot, and athleticism. It's never been done in our league. Never had a guy that's 7 foot who can do all that, so it sets him apart. Kevin, I'm 6 feet tall, and I can rush that.
You can, and you can write, and by the way, in the Hall of Fame. D.A., thank you.
I mean, I like the call. I thought the defense was just there a little late.
Rivers dishes to D.J. To the middle, cuts off the pass.
You can stay active on defense. Good things usually happen. Right there, quick hands help alter what would have been a sure two there.
And so he draws the shot, left trip to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, good job to take it right at
the. The Clippers not a team known for their defense, but quite often the last few years, it's been the deciding factor for them in games.
Yeah, I think it starts with the pressure they place on ball handlers. When they can throw double teams or pick up far out from the hoop, they've got shot blocking inside to erase mistakes as well.
And we know that DJ, of course, getting his nickname from his work behind the turntables, although, Greg, he's rededicated himself to basketball as he still does have a huge interest in creating his own music.
And as much as DJ loves DJing, he's going to have to find a balance between it and making it in the NBA. Hard enough to be successful at one passion, much less two.
Thompson against Rivers, and he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistle blowing.
Surprise, I'm still in.
That time, Hype came into play.
Well, you just watch the way that Klay Thompson shoots, and you're surprised when the ball doesn't go in.
I mean, one thing with Klay, too, in his shot, he believes it's always going to go in. More importantly,
the heck is that?
And he's got that shooter's mentality where he just will continue to trust in his mechanics, and I don't think he gets enough credit for just how hard he works to maintain that shot.
How am I not supposed to leave my assignment when he's all the way across the court? Thompson's got 16. Gosh. Game is trash. I don't know why I asked why. I thought it'd be more fun. But I mean, I'm not going to get put in at all in the second half.
Holding on. All right, Dave, thank you. And time now for the halftime break. Now the second half about to start up and begin any moment.
Oh, put me in, what? Fighters trying to play his son.
Setting the floor for the Warriors. We've got Durant. Bell is out there with Caspi. And there's Iguodala. And it's Thompson in at the one spot. And it's
Harold. He still missed.
Golden State's gone 2-2 from long range in the third quarter so far. From the baseline. And the shot falls short this time.
I still love the shot selection. The defense wasn't really a factor. You need to be more aggressive guarding the mid-range.
And that one's good, DJ.
Bring my team back.
DJ's on his way up. Surprised he doesn't get the and-one opportunity to go along with that basket. But that was pretty, pretty fresh.
I like that. Nicely done, Brett. Nicely done. LA's gotten fewer than half of their three pointers to go down tonight. They're 4-for-9. Brent, all things being equal, do you like the idea of sending everyone to the defensive glass to avoid giving away second chance points? Or do you like leaking a guy or two out in transition, hoping for the best?
I don't think the leak out is a good idea at all, Kevin. You've got to have five guys attentive to any possession. Most coaches in the NBA will tell you that a possession is not a stop until you collect the defensive rebounds.
Clippers trail by 11. To the paint. Reed gets the arrow.
Kill yourself. I want you to shoot.
Chance to cut the lead to single digits. Looking at Los Angeles, they want to turn it around after the loss to the Pistons. Thompson passes to Durant. The feed now to Casper. Back to Durant. Six on the shot clock. Bell's shot is good.
No one touched you. Get up.
First points in this one.
Skilled and instinctual enough to have the offense run through him. KD has become an expert at passing out of the pick and roll.
Off the pick. Here's Reed. Somehow ignores the tight D and gets the layup. Reed's got his first basket of the night.
His hard work on the backboard really just has given them more opportunities to score.
Golden State moving the ball around. There's the screen. Durant for three. Rebound by Harrell. Los Angeles has gone 1-4 in three-point shots here in the third. Rivers can't get it to go. Warriors leading by 11. Inside. Here's
Kessler. I want you to pass it back. I guess it doesn't matter because it went in anyways.
And after really leaning on that three-point shot in the first half, seeming like they're just getting away from it here in the second. More of the shots coming from the interior.
And stolen by Hill.
It's not a turnover if you don't have the ball. What's up?
Play in the paint continues here, guys.
What's up, Gavin? I'm raging a lot. This 2K18 is stupid.
Did you get one with Christmas?
Yes.
It's a buzzer beater.
No, it wasn't a buzzer beater. It was a timeout. It took me out of the game. There's one game, a couple games ago, they took me out for the whole second half, except for the last 5 seconds of the game. And what's the point of that?
And it's Decker in at the three slot. That's who's out there for the Clippers.
That's like Mel Cup.
What are you playing?
Just a bad decision. Absolutely no reason for him to be taking those shots.
I'm going to keep fouling until they fix the game. What are you playing?
But I'm watching YouTube, but if I play about my World War II in a second.
That one sniper sucks. It starts with a K, like carbon, I don't know, whatever it's called.
Car-90.
Yeah, that sucks.
That sniper is the best sniper in the game, bro.
All I get is hit markers.
That's the Lee.
No, it's the carbon. Or whatever it's called. I'll get on.
Wait, did
level
you get to
one.
Mountain? Oh, so it's probably the carbon.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking,
it's
yeah.
It's a semi, right?
Yeah, it sucks.
Yeah, the Car-98. That is like a god sniper. That's like the bullet stuff from BO2.
I'm not
but without the hit markers.
Come play. So it's like a Ballista, but a DSR.
Yeah. P-A-M-A-G-I-N-O. P-A-M-A. P-A-M-A-G-I-N-O.
P-A-M-A. I'll stop my stream. Because this game sucks anyways.